Let's try here on Lenovo Legion Go the game Heavy Rain. Well, at this point the game is running with 1920 by 1200 and high quality graphics.
He's a very solitary kid, you know, very focused within himself.
Let me show you fast the settings here. 1920 by 1200, as I said. Let's see if this will get us a full screen. No way. And I have the high quality profile active with some small changes.
Close to his mother. With me, he's more distant.
And what about you, Ethan? What do you feel?
I no longer want to live. I have no reason to continue.
Not even for your son, Sean.
I couldn't save Jason. Sean doesn't need a father like me.
Is there something else you wanted to tell me, Ethan?
I sometimes have these blackouts. Times when I don't know what I'm doing. I recover consciousness sometime later. But I'm someplace else. And I have no idea how I got there. Do you think this could be related to the accident?
You suffered a massive concussion and were in a coma for 6 months. We really don't know what effect a shock like that can have on the brain. That's the end of this session. We'll continue this conversation next week. You were lucky, Ethan. It's very rare to survive such a traumatic accident.
I don't exactly feel lucky, Doctor. Aren't you gonna go play with the other kids?
I don't feel like it.
How did things go at school today?
The teacher yelled at me for being late again. She's gonna send me home the next time it happens.
I'm sorry about that, Sean. Next time, we'll really pull it together, okay? Is something the matter, Sean?
No, I'm all right.
Do you want to eat something? want to go play on the swing? I'll push you.
Okay. Pushing Dad. Come on, Dad, higher. That was cool.
I'd like a packet of strawberry flavored chewies, please. Thanks. Hey, I got you some chewies.
I hate strawberries. Thanks. It was nice of you anyway.
A boomerang? You know how to use it?
No. Not really. I can never make it come back.
Can I give it a try?
Dad?
Do you want to give it a try?
I won't be able to do it.
Oh, come on, let's try it together. Now, the main thing is, get the right position at the beginning. Now, you've got to throw it straight and a little to the right. Now, throw it! Good job, Sean. See? That wasn't so hard. Like rain's coming. I think we better go.
Okay. You know, I didn't mean what I said before. I was just angry.
You were right to be angry. I wasn't very nice to you either. Get on. I'll get a ticket. One, please. That's a dollar.
Thank you. Do you think it's gonna take long?
No, he should be finished soon.
I'm off, Shirley, and I'll look at the reports later. I'll cancel all appointments for this afternoon.
Okay. Oh, Captain, Agent Norman Jaden from the FBI is here.
Jaden, of course. We've been expecting you. I'm in a bit of a hurry. Do you mind tagging along? We can talk as we walk.
Yeah, of course. I wanted to introduce myself before getting started, but perhaps it's a better time.
No, it's fine. I just have to get to the press conference. We have them every day now. Believe me, it's not always easy finding something to tell. Fortunately, today we have some news. Have you met Lieutenant Blake yet?
Yeah, we met this morning.
He has his own methods, but he's a good cop. I'm sure you'll get on all together. Do you know how to tie a knot in a necktie?
I guess.
To be frank with you, I could have done without the FBI on this one, but the press, they're all over us. This origami killer case crept up on us, and it's fast becoming a national concern. There are hundreds of killers in this country. What do you know? This guy is exotic. These flowers and origami figures. Work that one out. Then the press get onto it, and we suddenly become the center of the universe.
I'm here to arrest a serial killer. With all due respect, sir, the rest of it, it's none of my business.
Of course not. All I'm asking is that you make progress, and fast. The press want a perpetrator, and we're gonna have to serve him up on a silver platter. Well, I hope you're better at profiling than at tying knots. Ah, forget it, I'll manage. Oh, go see Charlie and she'll show you to your office. Just check in on the press conference if you're interested. It'll give you an idea of the political climate around here.
Thank you, sir.
Welcome to the club, Jaden.
As you get Perry's assistance, show me my office. I can't wait to get to work. Captain Perry is doing his press conference now. Might be interesting to have a look.
The body of Jeremy Bowles was found this morning on a patch of wasteland in the East End at about 6:30 a.m. 5 days after he was reported.
Thank you.
Nice watch.
Oh, it's the present we offer to our new lieutenants. We bought the same model each year for the past 20 years for each promotion. It optimizes everybody's time, and it's the kind of thing that always goes down well. You can contribute to our fund if you like, still a few dollars short.
Sorry, I don't have any change.
No problem. Maybe next time round.
Captain Perry said you could show me to my office?
Yes, of course. Follow me.
This is my office?
That's where I was told to take you. If you need anything, you know where to find me.
Okay, time to work. Step one, change the office. Victims in the last 3 years. All boys, aged between 9 and 13. No signs of violence. The victims disappear from public places in broad daylight. No one notices anything. Bodies found 3 to 5 days later, drowned in rainwater. Yeah. always the same ritual. An origami in the hand, an orchid on the chest. The victims have always been dead for less than 6 hours when they were found, which means they remained alive for several days before being drowned. Over 3,500 people questioned. Over 100 suspects interrogated. Not a single lead to go on. The killer's car is probably a Chevrolet Malibu 83. Here we go again. I better go wash my face. I need to take some. I'm gonna faint if I resist. That's all right. I know I can make it. I know I can make it.
This is Lieutenant Blake, Mr. Marshall. Could you please tell him what happened?
It was this afternoon. I went to the park with my son, Sean. We played together for a while. And then he wanted to go on the carousel, so I put him on one of the wooden horses. And when I turned back, Sean had disappeared.
Exactly what time did you arrive at the park? Try to remember exactly, Mr. Morris. Every detail can be important.
It must have been about... I think. I'm not really sure.
What was your son wearing when he disappeared?
He was wearing a coat. A brown coat. And a pair of pants. Black pants.
How could Sean have disappeared without you even noticing? Weren't you right by the carousel?
I didn't leave. I watched the carousel.
How could Sean possibly have vanished if you were right there watching the carousel?
I don't know. I don't understand.
You say you took your son to the park after school, but you didn't report him missing until 8:15. Why did it take you so long to contact the police?
I searched the whole neighborhood for him. I thought he couldn't have gone far.
All right. That's all the questions I have for now. You're free to go, Mr. Mars. We'll continue to look for Sean overnight. We'll contact you if we have any more questions.